Welcome. To understand calculation rules, it is good to have an example which illustrates them. As you know, speed is the derivative of distance over time. Using the fundamental theorem of calculus, it follows that distance traveled is the integral of speed as a function of time. This integral will help you understand all the rules of calculation explained in this video. Let us consider integrals with a fixed interval of integration. First, we consider what happens if we start traveling at twice the speed. Surely, the distance we cover in a given time also doubles. And if we multiply our speed by a different number, constant c, the distance traveled is multiplied by set c. Thus, we obtain the rule that the integral of a constant c times f equals c times the integral of f. Visually, we see that the height of the region under the graph is multiplied by c, so the total area is also multiplied by this c. Note that if the constant is negative, for example c equals minus 1, the region under the graph is reflected in the horizontal axis, whereas the area above the horizontal axis would count positively. After multiplication by minus 1, the area remains the same, but as it is below the horizontal axis, we have to count this area negatively. Thus, the rule of calculation still holds in this case. Now, suppose you're walking forwards in a slowly moving train. Your total speed with respect to the ground will then be the sum of the speed of the train plus your walking speed. In a given time, how much you go forward will be the distance the train traveled plus the distance you have walked in the train towards the front of the train. That is, if f represents the speed of the train and g represents your walking speed, the integral of f plus g equals the integral of f plus the integral of g. We see that the area under the graph of f plus g equals the area under the graph of f plus the area between the graphs of f and the graph of f plus g. This latter area is a deformed version of the area under the graph of g, where at each point the area is shifted upwards by a different amount. However, these vertical shifts do not change the area, and thus the area between the graphs of f and that of f plus g equals the area under the graph of g. Once again, we see that our rule of calculation is valid. Let's now apply these two rules in combination in the following example: the integral from 1 to 2 of 4x cubed minus 3x squared. We can split the integral as the integral from 1 to 2 of 4x cubed dx plus the integral from 1 to 2 of minus 3x squared dx, which equals 4 times the integral from 1 to 2 of x cubed dx minus 3 times the integral from 1 to 2 of x squared dx. As we know that the integral of x to the n equals 1 over n plus 1 x to the n plus 1, we can use this to calculate these two integrals and obtain 4 times a quarter x to the power 4 between 1 and 2 minus 3 times a third x cubed between 1 and 2, which equals 4 times 4 minus a quarter minus 3 times 8 third minus 1 third, which equals 4 times 15 minus 7 equals 8. These rules of calculation also work for indefinite integrals. For example, we could write directly the integral of 4x cubed minus 3x squared dx equals x to the fourth minus x cubed plus c. Finally, a word of warning. For differentiation, you learned the product rule and the chain rule for products and compositions of functions. For integrals, there are no simple rules to obtain the primitive function of f times g or of f of g of x. At university, you will learn some techniques which will help with these cases. Now, let's apply these rules of this video to calculate a few integrals.